center, 6'10", number 15, and forward, 6'9", number 20,
it's the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Kevin, thanks very much. The Hawks are one of the most dangerous scoring teams in the league. Trae Young says, we have guys who can make shots and make threes and really get our offense going. We can put up points really quick. We always have a belief that we're in the game. Guys, back to you.
Well, with a guy like Trae Young, it all starts with him. David, thank you. Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. On the block, it's Tucker next to Embiid. De'Anthony Melton out there with Maxey, and it's Harris in at the three set. And for Atlanta, Collins and Capella man the post positions. The guard pair, the talented Young and Murray, and it's Hunter in at the three spot. And Greg, the Philadelphia 76ers have made it very clear that they are all in on a title run.
And their front office has been very focused on trying to get top-tier talent on this roster. After the trust the process here, they're now aggressively pursuing titles here in Philly.
So Atlanta will get the first possession. Murray with it. Collins, a screen on Melton. Wide open look here for Murray. Shot clock reset for the Hawks. Whoa, hammering it in!
It's a joy to watch how active Capella is on offense, fighting for the boards and saving that play.
Embiid with a screen on Young. For the three. Doesn't go that time. And it's the Hawks taking it the other way. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of Philadelphia this year.
Well, these two teams will see plenty of each other as this is the first of four contests between them this year.
They know each other very well, and they'll be getting to know each other a lot better by season's end.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
You know, almost every team has some kind of roster turnover in the offseason, so, Greg, this time of year can be about getting familiar with your new teammates.
There's always a feeling out process this early in the schedule. It's about finding your team's identity, figuring out how all the pieces are going to fit.
Melton hits them both. You know, Smitty, last year, the Hawks' top four leading scorers were all 24 or younger. That is amazing.
It is, Kevin, and at the top of that list is Trae Young. He's a player Atlanta can build around. It's a matter of finding the pieces to put around Young to complement his game.
Connects from three-point range.
Does a good job of making quick reads and quick decisions off ball screens. Young always looking under control.
Now, here's Maxey. He seems to always be finding ways to score, averaging around 23 and a half points a game.
Mano y mano. This is where it can get a little personal.
Sometimes it's a matter of pride, answering back with a three of his own.
And here is Murray after the three-pointer from Joel Embiid. Here's Young. Tried to bank it in, but he misses. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Melton kicks to Maxey. Right wing. Capella against Embiid. Down low. Five on the clock. Tucker a screen. Here's Melton. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. The Hawks have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Young passes to Capella. Young against Harris. The three. And again, Atlanta with the triple.
Another area where Young excels, using the dribble to create space for his shot.
Maxey looking it over. To the paint. Tries it from 9. And misses it off the right side of the rim. The Hawks leading by 3. It's Young on the wing, guarded by Harris. Another miss by Young. And here's Melton. He'll bring it up for Philadelphia. Pass to Maxey. Philadelphia moving the ball over. And Trey Young gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. First quarter of play. We're about 3 minutes in. Harris against Hunter. Embiid inside the line.
I love how hard Capella works on defense. Doesn't want to give up anything easy.
Maxey against Murray. Here's Young. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Young's got 8.
He's hot this quarter, getting the shots he wants, and he's delivering.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Now, here's Maxey. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And Capella sends it back. Now, here's Murray. Outside Collins. Five to shoot. The Hawks need to get off a shot here. Shot's good from Young.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they shot the basketball. And Collins has shown to be a game changer on the floor. The problem for him has been staying on the floor. Has fought the injury bug his whole career.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here for the Hawks. The Kongwu's checked in for Clint Capella. Frank Kaminsky comes in for Collins. And Justin Holiday subbed in for DeJounte Murray. And then for Philadelphia, Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Joel Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for P.J. Tucker. And Matisse Thybulle subbed in for De'Anthony Melton. For Collins, he has yet to play close to a full slate of games, Greg, in a single season.
Collins has missed time in each season he's played. He's young enough. A few years of good injury fortune can change the narrative. And let's just hope that's the case for his sake.
Now here is Holiday. After the miss from Tyrese Maxey. Here's Hunter. Young trying to break free. Hunter no good. The 76ers trail by 8. Outside, Maxey. Pass to Harris to stop the run. Bangs home the trifecta.
Inconsistent from range when he first entered the league. Tobias has turned that completely around.
Young pass to Kaminsky. Three-pointer. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
And that one, they owned the backboards. Most of the second chance opportunities went to them.
They were able to convert a lot of those offensive rebounds. That's the key, generating points off those extra possessions.
Harris, no good.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on them.
Hunter kicks to Young. Now, here's Hunter. He's guarded closely. And as it goes out of bounds, Atlanta able to keep the ball here. Aaron Holiday is checked in for Trae Young. George Niang, he's checked in for the 76ers. Shake Milton comes in for Maxey. 1:15 left in the first. Kaminsky kicks to Holiday. Shot clock at 6. They set the pick. Over Harrell. From 8 feet away, he drops it in.
Resourceful move there. That was not an easy one to convert.
Especially given the height disadvantage. I love the way he created space for his shot.
Now here's Harrell. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
And NBA All-Defense for 2 years running, Matisse Thybulle has been a game-changing defender from the minute he set foot in the NBA.
The 76ers have had two chances at the line already, making them both.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
The first one falls. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
And Holiday with the basket on the assist by Hunter.
Look at the pass from Hunter, wanting to get his teammates involved.
The 76ers trail by 8. 35 seconds left in the first quarter. To the middle. Here's Harrell. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
Montrezl Harrell, shooting 1.
What I appreciate about Harrell is how hard he's worked on his skill set. The jumper, the post moves, and the pass.
Now here is Holiday. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Kaminsky sets the pick for Hunter. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. And the Hawks lead by 7.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Here's Milton, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Out left to the wing, Korkmaz passes to Niang. That 3 off the mark. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Hawks lead by 7. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. Here, guys, the scoring breakdown for Atlanta.
Well, in my opinion, the way the 3 has been falling for them here early on, you have to think they'll keep firing away.
And I really liked how they moved the ball tonight. Because of this selfless approach, they are piling up the assists.
The 76ers trail by 7.
Well, this Hawks team can run into defensive issues. Don't have many perimeter stoppers, and the interior at times can be overwhelmed.
So to begin the second quarter for the Philadelphia 76ers, D'Anthony Melton out there with Shake Milton. Then there's Embiid, and it's Niang in at the 4 spot. Milton with the ball, and Holiday picks him up defensively. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Hawks. Hawks making a switch here. Comes checked in, and then for Philadelphia, P.J. Tucker comes in for George Niang, and Maxey subbed in for Shake Milton. Here's Young. His last outing, we saw him pour in 22. And for Atlanta, Greg, on-ball defense can be a problem.
The team knows it's their weak spot. Have solid post defenders, great offense, but they'll be limited until they figure it out defensively.
Now, here's Maxey. After the miss from Trae Young.
Yeah, the defender all over.
for Philadelphia. They have shot 80% from the line tonight, going 4 of 5 so far.
Taking two shots.
First one falls for him. And home court advantage can give teams a huge lift. Greg, how different is it playing in front of the hometown fans?
It's huge. I mean, they give you energy. You don't want to let them down. So you tend to dig a little deeper when you're playing at home.
And he can't hit the second.
And some added toughness on the roster. Something Philly knew they needed after last year's playoffs. The hope is adding scrappy veterans like P.J. Tucker and De'Anthony Melton will help them further this go-round.
Philadelphia with the ball. Following the miss by DeJounte Murray. Maxey against Holiday. It's good. And the Hawks lead has got down to 4 on the bucket for Maxey.
Doesn't get exactly the screen he wants, but turns out he doesn't need it.
And here's Young. He's got 11. Fires from deep. And they recover it. Here's Capella. And they convert it last on attempt number 3. Capella's got his second bucket of the night. Outside, Maxey. Embiid with a screen on Young. There's the pass to Melton. Embiid with it. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Embiid's got 5.
And the man just brings his lunch pail and goes to work. What sets Embiid apart is he does it with such ease.
The 76ers trail by 4. Here's Melton. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve.
Young pass to Collins. For 3, Murray. Maxey grabs the miss. 76ers have gone 3 of 4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Passes it to Tucker. Dishes to Embiid. Pass to Melton. Back to Embiid. Shoots over Capella. Embiid, no good.
No one on him. He committed to fading away. Probably could have taken more time with that shot.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2.
And it's the growth of Murray as a distributor has really proved to be a great point guard. There were questions about that early in his career.
And Greg, you can see it. Murray has really improved his passing.
He has a great sense of the court and spacing. Reads defense as well and can direct his teammates. Could see him being an elite passer in no time.
Harris has checked in for Daniel HAWKS. And so Murray nails both of them.
And a big trade this last summer was Murray coming to the Hawks. Paid a hefty price, but Atlanta feels he and Trey make a great backcourt pair. Hard to think of a more deadly backcourt in the East. Hey, dunks aren't always for the big fella.
A serious power move from the point.
Forget just landing in. He wanted to make a statement.
And the call will be against Harris. That's his first foul. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Here's Young. Lays it up off the glass. Young's got 13.
Whether it's on the drive or from the outside, Trey Young is a problem. A dangerous score.
Maxey kicks to Embiid. Finds himself wide open and drills it. That's 7 points for Joel Embiid.
That was big because they dug a big hole in the first quarter, but starting to show signs of life.
Pass to Young. Fires the 3. It's good, and it's his sixth make against 11 attempts.
And let's see, guys, if that triggers another little explosion from him after hitting three triples in that first quarter.
Maxie against Young, and slam dunk by Maxie.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Now, here is Young. He's got 16. Another three for Atlanta.
And what a huge performance for him. I mean, he drained three three-pointers in that first quarter, and he's got two more here in the second.
Here's Maxie. Here's Embiid. It's good for his fourth bucket of the night. He's shooting 4 of 8.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game.
All right, man. Let's give it up for you.
And the Hawks will go for a different look here. Okongwu's checked in for Capella. Kaminsky comes in for John Collins. Hunter's checked in for Justin Holiday. And Aaron Holiday is subbed in for Young. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for P.J. Tucker. Matisse Thybulle checked in for Milton. And it's Shake Milton in for Maxie. There's Milton following the score by DeJounte Murray. Harris's shot is off.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's +5 in that category.
And it's Hunter with the jam.
Beautiful creativity off the dribble. That's a slick move by Hunter.
AGA, what about these Hawks? They can really be fun to watch.
Yeah, and they just need to be more consistent, Kevin. It seems they can beat anyone on any day. If they can start doing that regularly, we're talking about big things in the future.
Here's Holiday after the basket by Montrezl Harrell. Holiday, the pass to Hunter. Back to Holiday. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The pass to Kaminsky. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Kaminsky's got the lead up to 9 now for the Hawks.
Aside from the rim runners in this league, most bigs are now asked to help stretch the floor.
Milton finds Harris. Harrell, a screen on Kaminsky. Here's Harris. And it's sent back by Okongwu. Murray right side. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Harrell. Side Holiday. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
And this is what happens when you start to break your opponent's spirit. The resistance is no longer there.
Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Beautiful catch and shoot. Look at the pass right on time. And Tobias, he knocks it down.
Here's Murray. Some solid defense from Harris.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Passes it to Milton. Back to Harris. And that one drops. 8 points for Tobias Harris.
Nice bucket. The polished inside game. Something Harris relies on.
And so it's Atlanta with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, guys. Joined by Doc Rivers. Coach, what did you think of the effort in the first half?
The effort's fine, I guess. Defensively, we got to be better, so that's part of the effort. But they're just scoring too easy. They're throwing us around. They are so much more the physical team right now, so we got to pick up our physicality.
I'm sure that will be discussed thoroughly before the next half. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
Hey folks, halftime here. and it's been the Trae Young Show through the first half.
They've been dialing his number, and he's answered the calls. His teammates know he's feeling it. Credit them for being unselfish and getting him the ball.
Feed him every possession. The big dog is hungry.
You know about big dogs being hungry, man. You are the big dog, and you stay hungry even today.
And now we can turn our attention forward. Let's take a look at what lies ahead on the schedule.
The slate absolutely gets your attention. No easy games. This could bring out the best in the team. It's a measuring stick on how far they've come and how far they have left to go. I expect them to come out looking to prove a point.
And that concludes halftime. Now time to send it over to Kevin Harlan as the game's about to resume.
And as we get into this team, able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet.
It's been one outstanding game from Trae Young.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
This is his challenge, to continue to dominate, to help them try to close strong here in the second half.
The guard pair, the talented Young and Murray. Collins and Capella man the post positions. And it's Hunter in at the small forward. So that's the lineup for Atlanta.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
He gets it in there.
Good scoring feel by Trae Young inside, finding a path to a beautiful shot.
Here's Maxey following the basket by Trae Young. And Capella sends it back. They recover it. Embiid sets the pick for Melton. Another miss by Philadelphia.
They've come out ice cold to start this half. Three misses in as many attempts.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
In the paint, Capella can be so aggressive. The foul isn't going to hold his shot back.
And Smitty, we know with Clint Capella, one of his great skills is his pick and roll ability.
He is a great partner, Kevin, in the pick and roll set. Set solid screens, draws help defenders, finishes strong. Guards love having Clint as the roller for them.
And the first one at the line is good. And one thing, Greg, we know Capella has always done, he plays to his strengths.
It's a great point, Kevin. Capella knows where he's best and really focuses on that. Can help the team with minimal touches on offense, but he really anchors a defense by not overextending.
You have to love the strong foundation Clint Capella gives his team. He's incredibly reliable in the paint on both ends of the floor.
Now, here's Maxey. He's got seven. Pass to Embiid. It's hauled in by Clint Capella. Capella's got his fifth rebound in this one. Outside for Murray. Back to Young for three. A shot, no good. And it's Philadelphia the other way. Just over a minute and a half played here in the third. Melton passes to Harris. Now Embiid. And Embiid throws it down.
And if you want to talk about a player who embodies the power game, then Embiid's your man. You know you're going to get some strong finishes anytime he's on the court.
Now here's Murray. Checking some stats on him right now. He's averaging just around 22 and a half points a game. Here's Young. The Hawks again can't hit.
The will is there, but the execution is lacking. He can't seem to finish plays this quarter.
Pass to Maxey over Young. Rebound, Atlanta. They've led by as many as 11 points. Here's Murray, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on Embiid.
That's a great job drawing the foul, getting to the line.
Murray's crafty, especially for his age.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Shoot 2.
No good on that.
I love how DeJounte Murray plays with reckless abandon. He is fearless with his body, and that can often give him an edge against the D.
And Philadelphia making a change here. Niang's checked in. And the second free throw, good. The 76ers trail by 9. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Now, Maxey. He has 7. Shot clock at 5. Knocked loose. And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Murray, good.
Given Murray's slight frame, you'd think physical defense would bother him more. It doesn't.
Outside, Maxey, the pass to Melton. Embiid with a screen on Murray. Here's Melton. Here's Embiid. No one on him, and he makes the easy one. And that's 13 points for Joel Embiid.
Yeah, he's in such a great rhythm right now. Makes sense to get him the ball any way you can. Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
Phenomenal how many threes he drained in the first half, especially considering he's hit none since.
Here's Maxey, and he uses the glass on the way. Maxey's got 9.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
There is no let up in this man. He is doing everything in his power to keep this game close.
Now, here is Young. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Here's Niang. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Up top, Tucker. Outside, Maxey. And slam dunk by Maxey.
Now, that's what I call a momentum changer.
Yeah, when you've got a point guard with that kind of spring, no lead is safe.
You're totally right. That can be a shot in the arm for them. A spark that turned things around.
Time called here. The Hawks decide to talk it over.
Comes in for John Collins.
Justin Holliday's checked in for DeJounte Murray. And Aaron Holliday's subbed in for Young. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Joel Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for P.J. Tucker. Matisse Thybulle checked in for Melton. And it's Shake Milton in for Maxey. The shot by Okongwu, no good. The 76ers trail by 5. How about this run, Craig? They're on right now. Wow.
I mean, they're just getting to their spots and executing. Really keeping things simple.
And a quick look now at the best free throw shooting team. Number 5, the Hawks.
You know, it's really a team-wide talent. You want to foul to stop playoffs, but against them, you're not saving much. They'll make you pay time and again.
And a closer look here at the hustle stats for Atlanta.
What I love, and the coaching staff has to love, is the defense. They've really brought the energy with all these blocks we've seen in this one.
And just a great job converting those second chance points as well. They're having a great night getting those second and third shot
opportunities.
And he can't get the second one to drop either. Coming up empty that time.
I can't believe he missed those shots. Wow, he is usually lights out from there.
Smitty, you got to love how the big man Okongwu is developing.
Kevin, especially from a defensive perspective, he defends the rim with confidence. And I also like his shot selection.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. Korkmaz, nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Harrell, a screen on Hunter. Korkmaz passes to Harrell, and Harrell slams it in.
And when he's a roller, Montrezl Harrell can catch any pass because he has great hands.
Pass to Kaminsky. Inside, and finished off by Kaminsky.
Kind of aggressive defense they need to cut into the lead.
Yeah, you have to protect the rim, Greg, a little better.
Also, if you can't get stops at this point, it really doesn't matter what you do at the offensive end.
And Philadelphia has possession after the basket by Atlanta. Milton with it, clock at 4. Over Holiday. The rebound by Holiday.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Now here is Holiday. Here's Hunter. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Hunter's got 6.
Awesome concentration there. When Hunter's committed to scoring, he's hard to stop.
And here is Milton. Perilous screen on Holiday. Pass to Thibault. Now here's Harrell. Over Okongwu. And that one hits back iron.
You know, not sure if he's playing to the crowd, but no need for the fadeaway on that shot.
Hunter dishes to Holiday. And Holiday kicks to Hunter. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. And the basket by Kaminsky.
Boy, you have to be impressed with the offensive production. They have got it firing on all cylinders.
It's been a tremendous job of play calling and execution. They just continue to increase this lead.
Now, here's Milton, guarded by Holiday. There's the pick. Looking to end the run. And so it's the Atlanta Hawks looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. They've got their field goal percentage to thank for that. They've been hot from all over the floor tonight. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
This is why you preach teamwork. Some of the most spectacular plays are the ones where guys are feeding off one another.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. The Hawks leading by 13 on the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. On the block, it's Tucker next to Embiid. Maxi out there with Matisse Thybulle, and it's Harris in at the 3. Maxi against Young. The feed to Capella, and the dunk by Capella.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
This has been an impressive performance tonight. Even with a big lead, they've maintained their focus.
And Capella sends it back.
Nice discipline defensively for Capella. Does a great job of contesting shots without fouling.
And finished off by Collins.
One of the best young lob men in the business. John Collins finished with an exclamation point.
outside. Maxey. Pass to Embiid. And Tucker kicks to Thibault. From deep. Collins grabs the miss. Collins has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know. And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
And so it's Maxey who brings up the ball for the Philadelphia 76ers. Trailing by 19. The pass to Harris. Embiid with a screen on Howard. Harris, good.
Tobias Harris.
That's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
Reason why, it takes extra energy to do it. You have to trust your defensive rotations, but it's worth it.
And that one is good.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Up top, Maxey. Defended by Young. Maxey passes to Harris. And too much time in the lane, they get called for the 3-second violation.
And it's easy to give up after a play like that, but this team needs to keep fighting.
It's just one trip down the court, but you have to have short memory in this league or you won't last long.
Hunter's checked in for Justin Holliday. De'Anthony Melton, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Now here's Murray. Young outside, takes a three. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Young's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Embiid kicks to Harris. Over Hunter. Harris misses.
Very surprising. He gets the ball where he wants it in a decent matchup.
Murray outside. And for a lot of up-and-coming teams, getting better defensively is the key to reaching, Greg, that next level. That being considered, what's the first step in that improvement?
A lot of times it's bringing in a great defender, like a Pat Beverly or an Andre Iguodala, a defensive anchor who also inspires his teammates to take that challenge.
Now, here's Tucker, following the miss by DeJounte Murray. Embiid. Oh, and the jam by Embiid.
You see that nasty streak Embiid possesses. Part of why he's a superstar. Great motor.
And great camera work showing up on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Here's Murray, Philadelphia getting their last shot to go. Fourth quarter of play and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Tipped away. And now the 76ers on the break. And there's a nice one-handed slam.
No hesitation. He just takes off and takes it the distance.
Yeah, he's a one-man show in transition. Impressive play, taking it right to the rim.
To the inside. Capella kicks to Hunter. Six on the shot clock. From deep three-point range, the Hawks again can't hit. The 76ers trail by 17. Passes to Maxey. Pass to Harris. Murray with it. He's against Tucker. And finished off by Collins.
Defensive breakdown. Murray attracts attention as a scorer, which opens up everything else.
Pass to Embiid. He kicks it to Harris. And there's the pass to Tucker. Embiid inside. Capella covering. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Team first.
And we know how good Embiid is at drawing fouls, especially in the painted area. He welcomes the contact.
Two shots.
The free throw drops for Embiid.
Really an underrated part of Embiid's game. Excellent as a foul shooter for a seven-footer, so you just can't hack away at it.
And so he's able to get one of two. Well, Greg, what can you say about Joel Embiid's growth from a leadership perspective? Pretty impressive, isn't it?
Tremendous, Kevin. Carrying the Sixers with everything they went through. Even though he came in second in MVP voting 2 years in a row, no player more important to his team than Joel Embiid.
Here's Young from the arc, and Philadelphia grabs the miss. Melton's got his fifth rebound in this one. Now, Maxey. We know, Greg, the league trending towards small ball, but some teams are having success playing two bigs up front.
And I think the key is having versatile big men. If they can space the floor and play in space, also be able to cover smaller players, why not get the added rebounding and rim protection?
Now, here is Young. After the miss from Tyrese Maxey, it's good. Young's got 9 points now in just the second half.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Hawks.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And with this effort tonight, grabbing their eighth win of the year.
And they'll take the win tonight, setting the tone in the first matchup of this four-game season series.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Trae Young.
High-level shot-making, what we got a chance to witness. He responded to good defense with better offense time and time again.
And looking at that replay again, just a big-time block right there.
And that has got to help the morale of this team. Let's see if that sets up a run here.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hawks. Mike Kaminsky, he's checked in for John Collins. Justin Holiday comes in for Hunter. And Aaron Holiday is subbed in for Murray. Holiday dishes to Capella. But three, just three to shoot. A shot by Holiday, no good. Here's Philadelphia. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Milton. It's Korkmaz in the corner. Another miss by Philadelphia. Young with the ball. And so it's the Hawks taking care of business in this one. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who's standing by with our player of the game. Take it away, David.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Trey, you guys had a look in your eyes tonight, so how satisfying was this win?
I mean, it feels great. It feels great getting the win. At the end of the day, I mean, I'm just here to help my team win, whoever we're playing against, and that's all I care about.
Well, you all certainly did what you had to get this win, man. Congratulations. Kevin, back to you.
All right, David, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Steve Smith, Craig Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Trae Young.